Still no word from Major Jorgen or Kaleo?
Everything within a kilometer of the spire has been locked down. No signal gets in or out of that zone.
I warned you that Gemini frequency mission was dangerous. If they're alive, it won't be for much longer.
We can't be certain of anything. If they're safe, they'll contact us. If not, Arkan will make a public spectacle of them.
Can't say I'd feel too bad about losing Kaleo, but Jorgen's a good man.
Regardless, any rescue attempt on our part would be suicide. Their fates are in their hands.
I'll alert you the moment I hear anything, but until then, we're just wasting time here.
We could all use a break to regroup. That includes you, Theron.
I'm too tired to argue. Oh, almost forgot. Hilo Viz asked to see you, Commander. Wouldn't say why, but it sounded important.
Commander, got a sec?
What's on your mind?
We're doing our best to keep the supply lines running, but most of the people I deal with aren't exactly philanthropists. We can't keep running this thing on goodwill and borrowed credits.
Who are we accepting money from?
Better if you don't know, but I'd really prefer not to be living off their kind of debt. But look, I didn't just come here with complaints. I know a guy with a habit of showing up when someone's in need. He's reached out with an offer we can't really refuse, much as I might want to. You should meet him.
So he's what? A loan shark?
No, just a liar. And a cheat. And a thief. The only thing to trust about him is that he can do what he promises. Hear him out. Come on.
Well, this has been an interesting diversion, but I think it's time to wrap things up. I call.
Come on, Lana. Now? I fold.
So soon? Must be quite a hand. Let's see it.
But how? You discarded every chance you got and never locked a card the whole round. The odds are astronomical. You cheated.
Yeah, even if I did, you sure the old boss of Sith Intelligence wants to admit some shifty alien got the better of her?
Wasted no time turning the card table into a graveyard.
It's my preferred method of execution.
Commander, the most untrustworthy scoundrel I know. Untrustworthy scoundrel, the Commander.
She never was big on formalities. Galt Renault, at your service.
How is it you two know each other exactly?
Oh, we go way back.
I don't know. Seems like only yesterday that we first met.
Anyway, we really should get on to business. The Eternal Empire spent the last 5 years pillaging every world in the known galaxy. Now, how'd you like to turn all that plundering into a profit for you and yours?
I'm listening.
I happen to know where they're keeping all that ill-gotten game. Better yet, I've got a surefire plan to steal it right out from under their noses. I just need the help of a few talented, tough customers to see it through.
What's this generous offer going to cost me?
Only your word for now, and an even split after the fact. 50-50, couldn't be more fair. Ever heard of the Gilded Star? I'll stop you there. You haven't. It's one of the Eternal Empire's most tightly guarded secrets. A floating treasury circling the depths of a massive gas giant. The ship and the buried treasure all wrapped up into one neat little package. Well, maybe not little. By my estimation, it's the greatest sum of wealth gathered in one place since the Hutt Empire was a thing. So, you in?
I don't think I need any more reasons to say yes.
I hoped you'd feel that way. When you're ready to get this show on the road, we'll be heading to Vanden to lay some groundwork. Looking forward to this, partner. he is, Vanden. Mind the ledges when you're walking around unless you fancy a death by scenic view.
You haven't mentioned why we're here.
Giant barge full of money. Is this ringing any bells? It's out there somewhere, swimming below sight and scan range. Something about the magnetism here plays havoc with sensors and cheap fillings. Bottom line is, we'll never find the Gilded Star out there, which is all the more reason to get our preparations underway. Such as picking up the last member of our illustrious crew.
How many people are we going to need?
Half a dozen, give or take. This is the last one unaccounted for. Should be in a warehouse not far from the dockyards. I'll point out the place when I see it. So, this plan I mentioned, it's going to take the best identity forger this side of the galaxy to pull off. Problem is, he's been in hiding, specifically in that, for a long time. He probably won't be too thrilled to have visitors. Especially not visitors who had his safe house shipped a few thousand parsecs unannounced. Be on your toes.
What makes you think he'll cooperate?
Oh, he'll come around. Is it? They always say retirement's a good time to travel. Why don't you come and check out the new scenery?
Tiresias, you've got a lot of nerve showing your ugly mug to me again.
Tiresias?
Just a name I carried around for a while, no use to anybody now. I think you've got me confused for someone else, friend. Name's Galt Renell. Got a business proposition I think you'll want to hear about.
You can't play dumb with me, Ty. I know that face better than you do.
What do you mean?
He's seen a lot of my work. I even made him a perfect duplicate. Better than perfect. My version didn't talk. I've had enough of helping that fraud fake his own death. This time, it's gonna stick. A little for your hospitality. You can fail to just about anything.
Seeing stars.
Or a drink. Make it both.
Hey,
still can't roll with the punches. You perfectionist types never learn. There's no such thing as a sure thing.
Why are we trying to recruit someone who wants to kill you?
He's the one with the crotch! After I made that body double, he went to swindle half of Nar Shaddaa in my name!
Because Dretcher is literally the only one I trust to pull this off.
It's taken everything I know to stay hidden in this little prison. Every time I start to think I can leave, someone snitches on my new identities.
That true?
So maybe I encourage Dretcher's early retirement. This little box is cozier than a coffin and a better place to reflect on how stupid trying to blackmail me was. But hey, ancient history, am I right? I'm more than willing to forget about our past disagreements if you do one more job for me.
Like I never help you again.
He's asking, I'm telling. You're going to help us with a heist, or I'm going to rip you out of there and beat you within an inch of your life.
There's 25 layers of durasteel and cortosis between you and me. We'll both be dead of old age before you make good on that.
It's true, we might never get into that safe room of yours, but I'm sure this sonic amplifier I brought will have an interesting effect on the contents. So unless you want to spend your final moments being shaken to death by the dulcet tones of the Kashyyyk Life Day Choir, I would reconsider.
There have to be laws against this. Broad intergalactic laws.
This? Now, maybe a noise ordinance at best. Sit tight, Dretch, and get reacquainted with the concept of hygiene. We've got one more stop to make before we get to the fun part. Punctual, gentlemen. Glad you could make it all this way. No trouble acquiring my little request, I take.
It's here. You got our money?
Of course, friend, but I'd be remiss if I didn't ask to see the goods first.
That's a fine piece of hardware.
That should do.
You got our money?
About that. I was really thinking we should renegotiate the price. You know, seeing as I don't need the whole missile. Yeah, I thought you might feel that way.
Launch sequence initiated. Target acquired. Total atomic dispersal in T-1 minute.
You son of a... Make it stop!
Nah.
Hope you're a good runner.
Jumping might be faster.
T-minus 55 seconds. Warhead primed. Suffering index set to maximum.
You're gonna pay for this!
Suckers.
Abort sequence aborted. No stopping me now!
Ah, what did she do to this thing? Come on, it's not responding!
If I die because you wanted to stiff your dealer, there won't be a Corellian hell far enough to hide you from me.
Less threatening, more helping.
Tampering detected. Emergency detonation in 5 seconds. Nice try, jerks.
Now, I cannot tell if she did a terrible job rewiring this or too good a one.
3. Oh, so close. 2. I can't wait. 1.
That was great! Come on, that was pretty good. Admit it.
As pranks go, high marks.
Don't encourage her. Allow me to introduce my partner, Vet. She has a habit of getting where she's not wanted. Like on your nerves, for instance. Did you get the warhead, or were you too busy practicing your lines?
Yes, I got it, Grumpy Pants.
Though I guess those lizard brains will have figured out nothing's exploded by now. I'll see if I can't distract them.
Time to make ourselves scarce. We'll see you back at the hideout.
Toodles!
If you're still wondering why you're here, it isn't to check out the Tabana gas bars. There's a stealth cruiser loaded with more precious metals than a Hutt's taste in art hiding down in the lower atmosphere, and it's about to come up for air.
And while the Gilded Star is roosting at the Skyhook for its annual resupply, we're going to rob it blind.
How do you even know about that?
A little bird told us. I speak stool pigeon.
Even if you do know where it's going to be, it's got a full military complement on board. And a vault that could survive the ship being reduced to atoms.
Most people would consider it impregnable, but we aren't most people, are we, Senya?
You do seem to know a lot about our target.
Yes, well, I should. Overseeing the Gilded Star was among my duties when I still served Valkorion.
Then you are privy to its operational protocols.
I doubt they're still the same.
You don't have to run the thing. Just get Scorpio to the ship's control center.
There's no way we could infiltrate that far into the ship undetected.
Maybe, maybe not. But I'm pretty sure High Justice Valen can go wherever she pleases.
You're gonna have Senya pose as Valen.
We've got the best identity doctor this side of the galaxy, and as close to a genetic match as we're gonna get.
I could never match Valen's gene sequence like that. Although, maybe simulating data corruption in her IT.
And create enough doubt to bluff her way through. Dear old mom can manage that, right? Once Valen and her attaché droid are on board, they head to the bridge, seize control of the ship, and allow the rest of us to do our parts.
Like cracking the vault. It isn't controlled by the network, so I've got to get into the guts of the ship to reach the mechanism. I'll need your help.
Meanwhile, Lana and Koth will bridge airlocks with a tanker transport I've secured for the goods.
How are we going to carry an entire treasury's worth of loot out of the vault before anyone catches on?
Oh, we won't be carrying anything out of the vault. Into, that's another story. Remember how Senya mentioned the vault could withstand everything outside being vaporized? Same applies to what we're setting off inside.
The warhead.
Exactly. I'll be pulling up the rear with a disintegration bomb. Once it's done its job, we pump the atmosphere into the waiting tanker and make our escape.
What's the exit strategy?
Once that sucker explodes, the crew's going to notice. Everybody's just going to have to hightail it to the transport before they catch on.
Now, since we've got less than a day before the Gilded Star rolls into port, I suggest everybody get real familiar with their part. I picked out a discreet vantage point near the Skyhook. Better get in position. This is close enough. And there's the Gilded Star, just like I promised.
getting shinier.
Gold-plated and stealth ship don't exactly line up. Now we just have to hope Mommy Dearest remembers her daughter's birthday.
I can kill you from here, Gold.
Great, really getting into the spirit of your character, at least from what I hear.
Shut up.
We are approaching the checkpoint. No further communications are warranted until the bridge is under our control.
Roger. Break a leg, ladies. It's in their hands now. All we've got to do is wait.
Once they open the way for us, all we have to do is get this bomb inside the vault.
Assuming everything goes according to plan. But hey, if something has to go horribly wrong, now's the best time. For us, anyway.
We're not leaving anyone behind, Galt.
Only kidding. I'd never abandon a close personal associate in their time of need.
What about that thing with Kai?
He was an idiot.
True.
I am now in complete control of the Gilded Stars network. I will isolate the vessel's sentinels to the best of his system's ability.
Showtime.
Here, help me with this panel. Okay, I ought to be able to reach the vault mechanism along this route. Keep clearing a path for Galt, and I'll see you soon.
I really, really hope they check for Minox.
Are you sure those schematics were scaled in meters? I can hardly move.
My last partner didn't complain nearly this much.
Your last partner was crushed to death.
And never once complained about it. Okay, Vet, I'm here.
Just give me a sec.
Time's a factor.
Hey, you want to cut through a foot of cortosis and steel while hanging upside down in a half-meter crawl space? There. Jerk. Try it.
The moment of truth.
I've been rich, filthy rich, but nothing like this. Counting the zeros on a balance sheet can't even compare. There's just something magical about the real thing.
It's not ours yet.
Yet being the operative word. It won't look nearly as impressive in a second, but it'll spend all the same. Do the honors?
For the Alliance and freedom.
Payload's delivered.
It's time for the pay dirt.
Position. Extending umbilical. Seal is tight. All green.
Airlock disengaged. Awaiting order for depressurization.
Door is open.
Commencing depressurization.
Tank is filling. So far, so good.
Take approximately 10 minutes, 17 seconds to siphon a space of that volume.
Plenty of time to make our exit.
Great. Let's blow this joint.
I'm sure we've worn out our welcome.
It is unlikely the detonation went unnoticed. After we vacate the bridge, I will no longer be able to maintain a complete lockdown.
See? Perfectly justified acquisition. Come on, I want to try this thing out.
Just scramble the systems as best you can and leg it to the tanker. We'll see you there.
We're at capacity. Scorpio and Senya are on board. What's the situation?
We're keeping them busy on our end, but I don't think we're any closer to reaching you. Scorpio, do you still have any access to the blast doors?
Only through direct input.
Great. Just bug out before anyone notices you buzzing around. We'll take the Skyhook back down and meet you at the hideout. Play it cool. My guardian angel will handle anybody taking an unhealthy interest. Oh, boy.
The list's not coming, is it?
Oh, no, it's coming. It's just not empty.
Valen. I can sense her presence.
Time for Plan B.
What's Plan B?
Run and hope for a Plan C.
What about the escape pods or calling back the tanker to pick us up?
Too slow, not to mention it's our only bargaining chip if we get caught, and I'd rather wind up caught than take your other suggestion. We'd never be seen again down in that murk. The Skyhook's still the best option. There's just the matter of getting on. We have to go around.
There is no around.
There is out there.
You want us to scale the exterior?
Pretty much. Look, there's no time to stand here arguing, so I recommend lodging your complaints at a steady jog.
It's not so bad. Just don't look down. Or consider your own mortality. Goodbye, Spewy. I'll never forget you.
Okay, so, remember Plan C?
You never actually got to Plan C, Galt.
So Plan C is... jump!
Mother was here, again. She had the audacity to wear my face.
And a punishment.
Escaped. She knows I won't be bested the next time we meet.
Ah, empty threats all you've brought for me.
I interrupted their little raid on the treasury. They couldn't have accomplished much in the time they were here.
Perfect timing.
I'm not the one who has a problem showing up when I'm supposed to.
Jeez, how long are you planning to hold that over me?
The rest of your life, naturally. Thanks for keeping my worst half out of too much trouble.
It helped that you tempered my expectations accordingly.
Singing my praises again?
The lower octaves.
Anyway, I think we've all had our fill of Vanden, and it's gonna get a lot less hospitable shortly, so... shall we?
Let's get our haul back to Odessa.
There's nothing like coming home from a job well done, especially when you've ruined a huge jerk's day in the process.
Couldn't agree more. Come to think of it, our plan was lacking in one department.
An actual escape route?
It was the scenic route. Can't argue with the view. No, the one thing missing was a way to see the look on Arkan's face when he got the news.
I hope it has an effect on more than his ego.
I wouldn't expect an overnight collapse, but when His Highness's checks start bouncing, it'll shake things up. Count on that. Now, how about we get on with my favorite part and divvy up the loot?
Already taken care of. You, Vet, and Dretch are already paid out. I took the liberty of skimming what you owe me off yours.
Well, take all the fun out of it, why don't you?
Your idea of fun is why your divvying privileges are still revoked.
Just what did you do, exactly?
Ran out on me with the biggest score of our careers.
And I regretted it ever since. Well, after the shine wore off. A little older, a little wiser, you know? Okay, maybe a lot older. It was a formative moment. The point is we're onto bigger and better things, like melting a mint down into an ocean of liquid happiness. Now, however you want to spend your cut is none of my business, but if you want to, say, triple it, I might have a little something in the works.
This money isn't ours. I don't mind taking it from Arkin, but I want nothing to do with it.
It does feel wrong to keep it.
Our goal was to fund the Alliance, not personal gain.
Who says it can't be both? You just need a little ambition.
Or, you know, you could try giving. Maybe just once. See what you've been missing. My share is going towards buying back some of the artifacts stolen from my people. Freeing slaves. Giving Twi'lex a better place in the galaxy.
Honestly, we've got way more than we need for operations. It'd be good to have a plan for the excess.
I'd like to distribute our surplus back to the worlds Arkin plundered. I don't care how.
A fruitless gesture. That wealth will return to the Eternal Empire so long as they remain in power.
People are suffering out there. What are we doing if not trying to help them?
If you are confused, our objective is not to alleviate suffering. It is removing the Eternal Empire from power.
No fools in accounting, and no accounting for fools.
It appears our business is concluded.
Oh, I don't know. I figure you'll be seeing me around. You've got a handy little outfit here. Besides, I wouldn't want Hilo to get lonely.
As if.
If your Alliance happens to need a morale officer, I'm game. Kicking Arkin's butt should require a full-time party planner.
Speaking of parties... this stuff sells for more than most freighters. Grab some glasses and get to know what success tastes like.
Commander, Major Jorgen and Kaleo just landed. They're in the docking bay.
So much for celebrating. Go ahead, we'll be right behind.
Mission failure. We'll never get another shot at the target because of you. This is what happens when a criminal gets in the way of real soldiers.
You're welcome. Next time I'll let the enemy kill you.
We had them in a corner until you started tossing thermal detonators. I lost 4 good people because of your lack of discipline.
If they were so good, why are they dead?
I don't care what happened on Zakul. Just happy you two made it back in one piece.
A lot of people weren't so lucky.
That's on her.
It wasn't a complete loss. I grabbed something on the way out.
My fire team covered you.
Yeah, yeah. Point is, we lifted the data core from a security console right outside that hyperwave relay station. It's not the key to the Gemini frequency, but it does contain a massive file archive all about those droids.
I'll put Scorpio to work sifting through the information. See if there's anything to salvage from this fiasco.
Whatever's in those files has to make up for the lives that were lost getting them.
Nobody regrets those losses more than me, Commander. The casualties were unacceptable.
It could have gone much worse, but we can't let this happen again. Commander, I recommend these operatives be confined to base for the time being.
What? Forget that!
No, he's right. We didn't function like a team, and other people paid with their lives.
This is war. We can't always avoid casualties, but I expect you to get better at your jobs and work together. Dismissed.
You heard the commander.